Welcome to UroChannel. In this important video, I am going to explain to you how weight loss medicines like OZEMPIC and WEGOVY work. Now you may be asking yourself, why does a urologist care? As a loyal viewer of UroChannel, you know that I have pointed out the harmful effects of obesity time and again. Obesity not only threatens erectile function through diabetes, atherosclerosis, and high blood pressure, which sooner or later result from too much body fat, it also decreases testosterone and makes your penis appear smaller. There is even scientific evidence linking obesity to benign prostatic enlargement. So, we urologists have every reason in the world to promote weight loss for the benefit of our patients. If you have never watched any of my videos before, my name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. So, in simplified terms, OZEMPIC and WEGOVY, what do they do? Actually, drugs for weight loss are not a new thing, and neither that specific kind of drug, the so-called GLP-1 agonists. Almost 10 years ago, in 2014, Liraglutide, likewise a GLP-1 agonist, was approved by the FDA. You know, all of this emerged from research in the field of diabetes. Liraglutide has to be administered daily as an injection, but Semaglutide, which is the substance behind OZEMPIC and WEGOVY, is given as an injection once a week. In comparison, Semaglutide is more effective. According to the studies performed, Liraglutide was able to lower body weight by 8% on average and Semaglutide by nearly 15%. Furthermore, 63% of the patients on Liraglutide experienced weight loss of more than 5%, whereas in Semaglutide, 86% noted that effect. Let's take a closer look into its mode of action. Generally, there is a close interaction between the gut and the brain. This interaction is done via hormones and also via the vagus nerve. The critical brain structures involved are called the hypothalamus and the brainstem. The hypothalamus is a very important center in the brain with many functions. It kind of acts as a gatekeeper into deeper structures of the brain. GLP-1 is an abbreviation and denotes the glucagon-like peptide 1. It is produced in the gut, and when you have eaten something, it is secreted from gut cells and does several things. 1. It enters the hypothalamus via the bloodstream and lowers your appetite. 2. In your pancreas, it increases the release of insulin, thus enabling the muscles to take in sugar from the bloodstream, which of course lowers your blood sugar levels, which is a good thing. 3. GLP-1 delays stomach emptying, which means the continuous pressure in your stomach will make you stop eating. All of this will prevent you from becoming obese, theoretically. In practice, this doesn't work so well because palatability gets into the way. Some things just taste so good, you just can't stop eating. After you have injected semaglutide, which is a GLP-1 agonist, basically all of what I just outlined is happening. As a result, you will stop eating large amounts of food. But there is more. For some reason, you won't like junk food anymore. According to the Wall Street Journal, there is already a slight but notable decline in sales numbers by America's food giants and fast food chains. In plain language, while on semaglutide, you will become a vegetable lover, while the potato chips in your cupboard will become moldy. You will not only lose weight, but also start to eat healthy and become healthier. Sure, there may be a lot of reasons why obesity develops, but in the majority of people, it is very simple. They just eat too many calories, tightly packed and hidden in high energetic, high refined foods produced by a billion-dollar industry that knows every trick to make your taste buds go wild and craving for more. When I watch TV these days or read articles on the internet or watch videos on YouTube, it annoys me a lot when doctors warn you that you will have to take the medication for the rest of your lives. They argue that when you discontinue to use it, you will start to gain weight again. But I mean, that's logical, isn't it? When the drug is out of your system, suddenly the hitherto despised chocolate bar in the bowl on your kitchen table will look much more appealing again. Burgers will become your favorite meal again, and wow, that milkshake is really good. In other words, if you don't manage to keep up the good habits, naturally you will gain weight. So semaglutide has to be part of a structured weight loss program, preferably accompanied by regular counseling. And just think about it, a healthy diet high on vegetables, fiber, micronutrients has to be kept for the rest of your life as well. And if you don't want that, or if you don't manage to keep it up, you will continue to eat food that's garbage to your body for the rest of your life. It's a simple calculation. If you need to change your lifestyle but can't get it done, the risk for serious complications from diabetes, high blood pressure, increased uric acid, and increased overall inflammation is probably much higher than possible drug-related side effects. And don't forget, for the obesity-related diseases I just mentioned, you will have to take a bunch of medication to manage them. Their possible side effects combined outweigh the likelihood of side effects from semaglutide by far. The most frequently reported side effects from semaglutide were mild to moderate nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Recently, there were some reports of rare but serious side effects, that is depression and suicide in a few cases. Out of over 31,000 patients, 187 depressions were reported and suicide ideation in 73. That's 0.6 and 0.2%. If this was drug-related, and if so, why it happened is unknown so far. However, it reminded me of the threefold increased risk for depression and suicide after bariatric surgery for obesity. Hope I could clarify things a bit. If you want to know more, please talk to your doctor. And by the way, this video is not medical advice, and neither was I paid from any pharmaceutical company to talk about GLP-1 agonists, and I didn't receive any other benefits either. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.